and welcome to another edition of Between Two Foxes. Today we're filming in Marist's North Dining Hall. I have the pleasure of being joined by Tony Carrizales, Associate Professor of Public Administration in the School of Management. A few weeks ago, Tony was presented with the prestigious Board of Trustees Distinguished Teaching Award at Convocation. Tony, welcome. It's great to have you here with me.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here and be able to talk a little bit about my experience at Marist.
So Tony, in your acceptance speech when you received the award, you told a fascinating story about growing up in Brownsville, Texas, where so few of your fellow classmates went to college that you felt you needed to hide your acceptance letter to Cornell University. Can you tell us what it was like going to Cornell, how you navigated that transition, and how you came to feel that college was for you?
So growing up in South Texas was a great experience. The culture, the family, and higher education was emphasized. It was something that was important to everybody. However, applying to numerous colleges wasn't something that was expected. I applied to one college, got accepted, and found myself traveling to New York to attend Cornell. And it was a totally different world, totally different experience, having to learn to adapt everything from the food to the weather to the expectations of higher education. And so I used a lot of those experiences as a freshman, as an 18-year-old going to college, and I reflect on that now as a professor in higher education.
So many of our own students likely feel their own sense of trepidation coming to Marist. What advice would you give for them, even as we're still in these early weeks of their first semester?
The advice that I would give and that I took, learned along my way as a freshman in college was to engage. Engage through organizations, engage with the professors, attend their office hours, ask the questions, talk to your classmates about their experiences, where they're coming from, and learn about one another. You're only on campus for a short amount of time, and every interaction, every engagement is valuable. And so that's what really got me to open up my eyes to the experience of higher education and college experience, and I enjoyed my time at Cornell.
So much of the time, Tony, you're teaching graduate courses to mid-career professionals, many of them New York State law enforcement professionals. What is it like teaching such an experienced student body, and what do you learn from them as their faculty member?
Yeah, the Masters of Public Administration program really has a large population of first responders. So we have law enforcement, health professionals, people in public service that have spent many of their careers in the public sector. And so those experiences that they lived become part of the conversations that we have in the classroom. And so that's what really enriches the class and the room and the discussions of learning from one another and how we can collectively as a cohort of students learn and progress in as we advance and become leaders in the field of public service.
So in our conversations about growing up in South Texas, I've come to realize just how important food is to the culture. So tell me a little bit about what that meant to you growing up and how you're trying to experience that here in the Hudson Valley.
I look forward to visiting family because I know that as soon as I meet them, we're going to go out and eat and have some food that it's hard to capture. It's hard to replicate. I can't necessarily find it here. I can find something close to it, but it's definitely hard to find the right flavor and the right spices that really make that distinct South Texas food that I'm looking for.
So I understand you brought some hot sauces with you here today to share some of this culture with me. Is that true?
Well, one of the things that I appreciate about growing up in South Texas is that spice is a big part of the food. Growing up, my father, he actually competed in a jalapeno eating contest and he won. I think he ate like 30 jalapenos in like a 5-minute span. So I remember that about him growing up. My mother's the type of person that carries hot sauce in her purse. So that way, whenever she goes out, she can spice up her food just in case. Because the one thing I will note is that the tolerance for spice kind of skipped a generation. So I'm not a heavy tolerant spice person. My daughter is. Be interesting to see how we do in terms of assessing our level of tolerance with sauces and spiciness.
Well, I'm already sweating, imagining your father eating 30 jalapenos in 5 minutes. Now I'm really scared about what's coming next, but let's give it a shot. Let's go have some chips and hot sauce.
Sounds like a plan.
Excellent. All right. So now is time for what we call the lightning round, appropriate since we're about to have some hot sauces. How about you tell us a little bit about what I'm about to have to do with you?
Sure, so these came from Hot Ones Show. We have the more mild one, 2 out of 10 with buffalo hot sauce, Los Calientes, which is like a 4 out of 10, and then the Last Dab, which is an 11 out of 10 as marketed by the Hot Ones.
11 out of 10, that sounds hot. All right, so before we get going though, I need to grab a few things to help me through this. So a little bit of bread, a little bit to drink. All right, Well, let's dig in. This is the 2 out of 10, right?
Sure.
All right, so a couple questions for you here. Of the Six Flags of Texas, which is the best one?
I think the Texas Republic, the independent flag, always very proud of, Texans are very proud of their Texas identity, of it being an independent nation at one point.
Well, we're all really excited about the new Dyson Center being completed over the summer. What will you miss the most out of the old Dyson Center?
The rain coming in through the roof.
You're gonna miss that.
No.
All right, one last question before we move to the medium sauce. So I understand you and your family are huge fans of comic books and superhero movies. What is your favorite superpower of all time?
Of all the superpowers that I like, it would probably be one of invisibility. Being able to sneak in out of places, that sounds like a power that could be beneficial.
That would come in handy in my job from time to time. So what did you think?
I took a small amount of it just to get a sense of where it was at. I probably would have been okay with taking a little bit more, if not too bad.
All right, well, I'm really afraid of what's coming next now. All right, next question as we dip into the second sauce. Cornell Red or Marist Red, which is better?
Marist Red. Followed by Cornell Red and then Rutgers Red, where I got my doctorate. All schools of red, so.
As long as Marist is first, that's the right answer. So what is worse, a hot Brownsville day or a cold Hudson Valley day?
Oh, a hot Brownsville day. You can pass out in the heat walking down the street. A cold Hudson Valley day, you bundle up, you'll be all right. But the heat can get you.
I'm experiencing that right now. Last question on this sauce, New York Rangers or Texas Rangers?
I'm gonna have to go with the Texas Rangers. I'm not a hockey person. I know you're a hockey person.
That's also the right answer as a New Jersey Devils fan.
So. Okay.
So what did you think about the medium, the 4 out of 10 on the scale?
I thought this one was okay. I don't mind going, just getting a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit spicier than the first, but still manageable, I guess we could say.
Okay, I have a few more questions for you, but tell the audience what you're about to do and as I decide whether I'm gonna join you or not.
All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and try the last dab. I can smell it from here, so I'm a little nervous. I'm gonna go ahead and get some on it.
Okay.
And here goes nothing.
Wow, that was more than some. How are you doing?
So far, so good, but I can feel it.
Okay, next question.
Okay, I'm ready.
Rio Grande or Hudson?
I'm gonna go with that's a tough one.
Is it a tie?
It's a toss-up, yeah.
Okay.
And I think part of it is that I'm starting to feel the sauce.
I can tell.
My mind is not necessarily where it should be.
I am cheating a little bit. I have a sauce called Scorpion, which is not nearly as crazy as what you're having. We'll see what happens. And maybe I'll join you, maybe I won't.
Oh, the sweat.
You're not selling that for me. And this is extraordinarily hot too, for me at least.
But you did it.
I don't know about it. I did a little bit of it. So you commute to Marist from Yonkers, which means a lot of miles on the Taconic.
Yes.
How many speeding tickets do you have?
Zero, and I'm proud of that. One of the things I like about driving up the Taconic, it's very scenic. I put it on cruise control, not over the speed limit, put on an audiobook or some music and just enjoy the ride.
Excellent, Woo! Excellent. Well, thankfully, that's all the questions I have for you today. Well, thank you so much, Tony. That was a lot of fun, mostly.
I wish it could be say it was a pleasure, but it was an experience, that's for sure.
All right, so until next time, we'll see you on the next Between Two Foxes.
That was a good end.
I took too much.